Welcome to Research Creations, and thank you for clicking on this video. In this video, I will be covering the fundamentals of selective breeding, which includes mutations and selective breeding in plants and animals. I do hope you'd enjoy the video and learn a thing or two about selective breeding. Selective breeding is the act of human perfectionism. It tends nature to our needs. Selective breeding works by taking two parent organisms with the best characteristics, allowing them to breed and produce offspring, hoping to produce an even more humanly desirable combination of both parents' characteristics. Examples include breeding tomato plants that bear more fruit, or raising more muscular cows. Mutations are the phenomena that allow selective breeding to happen. Without them, offspring would be exact copies, or clones to a certain extent, to their parents. So what are mutations? Mutations are the spontaneous changes in a DNA sequence, and it in turn causes random changes in characteristics. You may be wondering, what causes mutations? Well, that is what I'm going to explain now. As we already know, mutations are changes in a DNA sequence. Mistakes made during cell division or exposure to ionizing radiation can cause those changes. An example of humans intentionally taking advantage of mutations was in the 1960s. Ionizing radiation was intentionally exposed to plants to induce a spontaneous but useful mutation. Humans have used selective breeding to manipulate all forms of organisms throughout history. Many things we take for granted wouldn't be possible if we didn't take advantage of selective breeding. In this section, I will be covering the selective breeding in plants and animals, explaining how it works and the changes we've made along the way. Selective breeding for plants has been around since the transition to agriculture around 12,000 years ago. It has changed our diet, our culture, and the basis we build humanity upon. So first, I'll explain how selective breeding for plants work. Let's take the corn plant for example. Corn originally was found in the wild by prehistoric humans and used to be thin, woody, and practically inedible. Farmers then started to grow said corn. Then at every harvest, they would select the crops that bore more fruit and were larger, and breed those together, discarding the unappealing crops. After generations of similar practices, selective breeding has created the large modern corn we are so familiar with today. Other examples of plants revolutionized by selective breeding are wheat, brassicas, watermelon, bananas, and much, much more. Animals and livestock have taken their fair share of selective breeding as well. Domesticated animals, such as house cats and dogs, would remain wildcats and wolves without our intervention. Like always, I will start off by explaining how selective breeding for animals works. Let's take the featherless chicken for example. Chickens used to be wild, feathery birds before being domesticated around 6,000 years ago. With the use of a similar process of selective breeding as used in plants, selecting the appealing animals and allowing them to breed and produce offspring. Now, the familiar featherless chicken is meatier, easier to process, and suitable for large-scale industrialization. Pets such as dogs and cats wouldn't exist without selective breeding as well. Other examples of animals influenced by selective breeding are the Holstein Friesian cows, salmon, and plenty more. Even though selective breeding may be useful for us humans and tends to our needs, but it does have some serious downsides in many sectors. In this section, I will be introducing and explaining some of them. First, it reduces the genetic diversity in a population. As more and more similar crops are bred together, gene diversity starts to narrow down until there are only the appealing crops left. If all the crops have the same genes, in the event that a new disease infects one of the crops, the entire population could be wiped out. Another disadvantage is inbreeding. Like I stated before, gene diversity starts to narrow down with selective breeding. And when two parent plants of similar genes breed, inbreeding could occur and cause the offspring to be prone to diseases and inherit unappealing defects. Thank you for watching this video till the end, and maybe learn a thing or two about selective breeding. Like the video if you enjoyed it, dislike it if you didn't. Sharing and subscribing to my channel would be much appreciated. Thank you for watching Research Creations.